We'll see if this recording gets out. It looks like I have several computers. It looks like we're being hacked every which way. Oh yeah. Those that make false allegations, they're always the ones, aren't they? Well, all right, guys, let's just get to it. I don't want to get into too much explanation of things because my computers are just all freaking out. Anyway, I've had three computers now. They're all doing weird stuff. No big surprise where we're at. Guys, I was actually laying down. I was going to go to bed tonight, and I heard the Lord say, "Jonathan, get up." A night in Eden. And I was like, a night in Eden, without getting into the whole backstory. Before the Lord called me, he moved me emotionally so intensely one night that I just wept in my room at my house where I was living, where I had three little children, and I was just in a situation where I was just crying out, like, I need something to change in my life. I have a person that I've had children that with now they use the children as weapons against me. They literally use weaponize their vagina by lying to me and telling me they were on birth control, and then using that is a way to leverage my life. And I was like, this is insanity. I've never seen anything like it in my life, and it was just pure evil. And I was like, you know what? And I was in my room one night, and I was just, what in the world is going on? Public broadcasting came on, and it was called A Night in Eden. So tonight, when I was laying down, I'd gotten out of a bath, but I fully intended to come out and do a video and show you guys what's going on with the Israeli conflict. This looks like we're at the very verge of everything. And the Lord woke me up after I went in my room and laid down for a little while. I fell asleep, didn't plan on falling asleep. I just fell asleep. But the Lord awakened me and said, "Get up, Jonathan. You need to go reach out and tell everybody a night in Eden." And I was like, "What are you talking about?" And he made me recall 25 years ago when I was sitting in my room just lamenting about what was going on. And Sarah Brightman, I didn't know who she was. She just came on public broadcasting. I'm gonna play a song called "Deliver Me," and I want to play it for you because it's what moved me to cry out to God, "Deliver me." You should go look up the words to it so you know exactly what words she's saying. You should pause my video right now. Go look up the words to "Deliver Me" by Sarah Brightman. Read the words first and then listen to her play the song. The world's at a tipping point. The sea is turning terrible before your very eyes, just like the prophetic utterance the Lord gave me. It's happening right now. This is it. We're at the moment in history, the tipping point. The Lord also showed me, "Jonathan, go look at the book of God, go look at the book of Judges, Gideon. It's a representation of the rapture." And I was like, "What? The rapture? Share it with everybody." I'm like, that's crazy. So even though in my spirit I'd kind of contemplated it before the Lord put it on me, "You need to go look it up and study it and look at it. I'm going to show that to you." It's mind-boggling what happened with Gideon and how it parallels where we're at today. I'm going to show that to you. I'm going to show you some of the stuff in Israel. And then I'm gonna play for you at the end, at that night where I cried out to God at the end of the concert was time to say goodbye. Just on a little super crazy note, so a really crazy note, I had to move a car and help somebody with a vehicle that was broken down the other day, and I needed, one of these rings so you could put a key on it. I needed to put their keys on something so I could give it to someone at a shop. And I was looking for one. I didn't really have one available. And I looked on place where I keep a lot of keys. And I saw one that didn't have any keys on it. I went, well, I could use that one. I want to show you what was on this thing. It said Jesus. And I just want you to look at that. It says Jesus. And it's a crown and a shofar. I mean, what are the odds? I couldn't have told you that I owned this. Someone sent it to me a long time ago. And of course, I was like, wow, that's super cool. And I hung on to it. But I put it in a place where my keys would be. But it's not, there's a whole bunch of different keys to different things. But in my need for one of these little rings to put a key on, I saw one that didn't have keys on it, and I went, oh, maybe I could use that. And this is what it was. So it's a shofar, it's a king's crown, it says Jesus. So I just thought, wow, that's very just impossible. Cool. Anyway, so now let me share this with you guys. Deliver me right now. If you haven't cried out to Jesus, if you haven't laid yourself naked, if you're afraid for anyone to know what you've done in your life, then you're not clear before Christ. If you have purged yourself and just admitted your sins, and if you're not afraid to stand naked with anything you've ever done and just say, this is what I've done, and I'm sorry, and I deserve my punishment. If you've done that and you've asked Christ to come in and take over your temple, then you're probably good to go. He will convert you. That means, when I do this, convert, the word convert means turn quite around. He will convert and invert you. You'll be able to see the truth, and you'll realize you're a prisoner here and that your host body is your prison. The shirt I'm wearing, it's 350, is anacrino in the Bible. It means to vigorously judge from down to up. That triangle is pointing up, representing up is good, heaven. And then this one on the other sleeve is pointing down, and it says instructor, going right side up and upside down, because I'm here to instruct you that you've been caught in a prison, and this is a demonic prison. Up and down is the demonic trap that you're in. So you need to get converted where your eyes become single, but your whole body's full of light, and you're no longer a slave to Satan, because until you're converted, you're a slave. Okay. My computers are doing all kinds of weird things. I've had all these hack attempts. It looks like maybe some of them have been successful. I have some plans for all that. But also, one of the channels that has just propagated the hate against me and all my people that come and watch this channel, which would be over the years, hundreds of thousands of subs. From a channel that barely can muster maybe, 700,000-800,000 subs, called Gene Rebel, just a hate channel. Those people, I got a call this morning and found out that his channel was taken down. Praise God. Well, and it wasn't me that did it either. So there you go. Fascinating. Anyway, let's go ahead and let's get Sarah Brightman going. I want you to listen to the song. Please go look up the lyrics to Deliver Me. But here you go. Phenomenal. Here you go. Ready? Sarah Brightman, Deliver Me. This was a point that where the Lord used this to just crack my heart and have me turn to him. And I was in a situation where I just needed something. I needed something good instead of the torture I was going through.
You're the one.
Now again, I just that song was a actually it was literally a turning point in my life. I sat there and I wept and I just like and I was crying out, just I need the courage to guide me. I need strength from inside me. I need someone to turn to because things had since my wife had passed away from cancer and then someone had orchestrated to get pregnant on purpose in order to try and control my life. I was just, my life had devolved into something that I almost couldn't imagine. It was evil. Some people had set evil out against me, and I was just like, this is just wrong. So anyway, and here I am. The Lord did deliver me. He delivered me with his spirit, and he changed my heart. He changed Jonathan Kleck forever. And since I became a servant of the Lord, the world has hated me. Before I was saved, it's like the world loved me, but I fit into the world. I don't fit into the world anymore. I'm just not part of it. I don't like it. The Bible says whoever loves the world or the things of the world has not the love of God in them. So anyway, so here we are. We're at the nexus. We are at a turning point. We're at a very serious moment in world history. If you're not willing to lay yourself bare before the Lord God, and you're not willing to admit everything you've done and who you are, you're just not ready. And if you haven't done that, have the courage to do it right now. Pause this video and cry out to God. Go tell one other human being who you are and what you've done. Just say, I've got to purge your soul. Purge it. Purge your entire soul. This is what I've done. Ask God to forgive you and ask Him to take up residency inside of you and give your life back to Him. I am just asking you, imploring you, please, if you haven't done it, please do it. Okay, now, guys, I'm going to show you some stuff that's horrific. I want you to understand when I prophesied back in 2007, out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind, water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the sea by the sea, and great shall be the destruction of that city. And behold, the great wall which holds back the abundance of the river shall burst forth, bringing the hand of the oppressor against you. For I have seen it, says the Lord, for mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. Now behold, the abomination of desolation spoken by Daniel the prophet, standing in the holy place where it should not be. Here is the mystery made known to you. You are the holy place of which I speak, and the abomination shall rise from within the walls of the temple to destroy the temple. For have you not seen and have you not heard? Has it not been made known to you? Have you not read the scriptures? For when the sons of God came in unto the daughters of men, they did bear children to them, and the same became mighty men. Has not the sea turned mighty? And the sea shall turn terrible before your very eyes. And the terrible one shall be elevated within the sea, and behold, the man of peace, Barack Hussein Obama, shall come forth from the sea, and with words of peace he shall bring chaos and destruction. Behold, the fig tree puts forth its leaves, and suddenly the time is upon you. Guys, it goes on, but it doesn't even matter. Do you not know? Can you not see where we're at right now? I've been under an attack for 2 years from people that I gave grace to. I showed them grace. I didn't sue them, didn't drag their mother into it, and all they've done is malign and hate me for years and set up other channels. Parroting the Gene Revel channel, by the way, which was canceled. I found out this morning. Someone I got a call and they said, hey, guess what? I was like, really? Well deserved. Anyway, so here we are. We're at a tipping point. I'm going to show you guys the horror of what's going on in Israel, in the Gaza Strip. What these people did, it shows them kidnapping women and children. The reports coming out, I mean, credible reports, not just pundits, credible reporting, lighting children on fire, beheading children. These are animals. This is a beast. It's not, there's a war between good and evil. That's why I have this shirt. That's what the war is. See 350, that's Anacrino in the Bible. That's up for heaven. For those of y'all that have been around since World War II, FUBAR, you should know what it means. It's upside down. And then this sleeve is a triangle that's down, representing the good and evil system. That's the real battle. The battle is in your own heart. And now it's manifesting throughout all of humanity. And humanity is changing. and the evil one is elevating within the sea of humanity, taking over the whole thing now. It's where we're at. Absolutely guaranteed. If you can't see it. So the days of Noah, the Bible says, my spirit will not strive with man, for he is mortal flesh. The Lord's spirit's not going to strive to try and get more people converted, I don't think, for very long. Because look at where we're at. The terrible one shall be elevated within the sea of humanity. So he's taking over the hearts and minds of humanity. The lies, the deceit, it's beyond the human brain now. But I want to encourage you, because I'm an end of the world harbinger before the fire. Noah was sent to warn everybody there was a flood coming. I was told to warn everybody there was a fire coming. I knew it the night I got saved. Do you see it coming now? It's been coming. And it's been easy to see. The Lord's let me reveal the mystery of everything. There's twin female energy from the pit that starts a host body system. The Lord God allows all angels have free will, and you're allowed to come in and take on a host body if you want, but it leads to imminent death. You basically got carried away captive because you were lied to. You were deceived, and you took the host body. You took the bait. And now there's good and evil within you. There's two different dimensions, spiritual beings that exist within you, an angel and a demon. And the war is only won when you surrender to the Lord God. That's the only way to win the war. When you accept Christ's payment on the cross, then you win the war. If you fight and you try and struggle, the tighter you struggle, the tighter the knot gets. That's the way it works. And Satan's got you. If you're in the flesh, he owns you. He has legal title deed to you if you're in the flesh, because you're a rebel. He owns the host body system because you're a rebel, because you're in it. And that's twin female energy from the pit. So the way out is to turn back to the Lord God with your whole heart and ask for forgiveness and lay yourself bare. Just get one other person. Tell them the truth of who you are, no matter how embarrassing it is, whatever you've done. That's what Satan wants. He doesn't want you to confess your sins. He doesn't want you to publicly shame him and tell the truth. Then publicly shame Satan. Just rat him out inside of you. It's a way to do it. I'm telling you. It's a way to do it. All right. So now, I believe we're at the very moment. The time is upon us, guys. So let's look at a little bit of what's going on in the reality of where we're at. Let it sink in for a minute. I don't want to play too much, but I want to play enough for you to understand this is real. But if you don't know the truth, then you're living in a false reality. If you haven't been converted, you're living in a false reality. I showed you guys the bombings of the Twin Towers are printed on your money. The Pentagon's printed on your money. The federal building bombing is printed on your money. So if you don't know the truth and you're not living in the truth, then you're living a false reality. The Bible says in Revelation 22, everyone that loveth and liveth a lie goes into the pit. All liars, all fornicators, adulterers, witches. They all go. All liars. People that bear false witness. If you haven't stopped doing that, you need to repent of it. And just admit to God who you are and what you've done. He'll forgive you. He wants to forgive you. He wants to forgive you. All right, so let's do a quick thing where we look at this atrocities going on. I mean, the things that are happening are beyond the human brain now. All right, I want to pray for right now. I want to pray for Karen Sullivan. I want to pray for Jim Sullivan, Kathy and Chuck Edge. I want to pray for their mother. I want to pray for all the people that are involved in the Gene Revel channel that are part of this hatred. There's an organized campaign of hating Jonathan Kleck. They're convinced I'm a false prophet, even though I lay hands on the sick and they recover. They're convinced that somehow I'm a false prophet, even though I've shown you the Vatican's a snake. They'll do whatever and say whatever because they believe it. It's somehow in their minds. They believe that someone that's doing the very works the Bible says will accompany those that the Lord God sends, even though I'm doing those works. They're convinced that somehow I'm a false prophet. Well, there's a word called delusion, and the Bible says, because they had pleasure in unrighteousness, God will send them strong delusion. I'm going to have to stand on that. So here we go. Heavenly Father God, I pray just for any and every person that hasn't accepted your free gift of life to accept it now. Anyone that is in a trap that they just purge themselves and they admit who they are and what they've done. Anyone that feels like they're in a blackmail situation or they're in a situation where someone is threatening them to do harm to them for any reason, that they just stand up and admit whatever it is they need to admit to get out of the trap that they're in and just shame the devil openly and publicly. Not to be afraid, to stand on the promises of God that you will forgive them. You forgave even your servant David that committed murder and committed adultery with Bathsheba. And he was your servant. He was a man after your own heart, and he slipped up and he made mistakes. But you didn't withdraw your love from David. And David was a man after your own heart, and you forgave him. And I pray that anyone out there in this world that thinks that God won't forgive them remembers that David was a man after God's own heart. And you forgave him even after you had anointed him and made him king. God's love is unfailing. It never ends. He's willing and ready to forgive you. Okay, guys, so please take the free gift of God, which is eternal life. Okay, now let's look at this stuff going on in Israel, just some clips. And then I'm going to play what was played at the night in Eden when I watched that all those years ago and just let you feel, hopefully, what I got to feel and understand, that God wants to get you into the fold. He wants you in. All right, let's go do this right now then. Deliver Me by Sarah Brightman. Please go read the lyrics. Okay, let's take a look at just some of this craziness going on over there.
Explosions rumbled through the night after Israel declared war on Hamas on Saturday. Hamas, a militant group from Gaza, coordinated an unprecedented attack early Saturday on Israel by land, air, and sea, shocking the country and the world.
מה שקרה היום לא נראה בישראל, ואני אדאג שזה לא יקרה יותר. נקה בהם עד חורמה, וננקום בעוצמה על היום השחור הזה שהם עוללו למדינת ישראל ולאזרחיה.
And a senior official in Hamas said Saturday's attacks are only the beginning of the conflict.
The country right now is just going into fight mode, survival mode.
Though Israel and Hamas have been entangled in a decades-long conflict in Gaza, here's why this attack is different, and what it could mean for Israelis and Palestinians.
This has never happened. Israel has fought many wars against its Arab neighbors, but it has never experienced anything like this, where Palestinians have actually come into Israel proper and committed such widespread attacks.
Hamas says it is dedicated to building an independent Palestinian state. The group controls...
Let me pause this for 1 minute. One of the things that's so unbelievable about what's going on right now is that the Israelis said now that the attacks are so violent because they were burning children, they were cutting off heads of children. And these are not just, the reports are coming through credible sources, and there's credible reporting on the reality that people are being kidnapped and just violently murdered citizens by Hamas. So we're just going to check that box briefly so you know it's true. Maybe not. You know what I mean? I don't want to show stuff that would be too much. But let's just check the box so you know what's going on.
Including Americans, what Israeli officials call their 9/11. Tonight, Israel's prime minister says airstrikes in Gaza are just the beginning.
We just started to hit the Hamas.
And now the race to find what Israel says are at least 100 hostages, with Hamas threatening to start executing them. Among those abducted, 25-year-old Noah Argamani screaming for help as she and her boyfriend are taken hostage by Hamas terrorists. This woman, barefoot, her hands bloodied and tied behind her back, her face bleeding as she's forced into the back of a Jeep, and a mother crying, clutching her two children as they're about to be kidnapped. The horror starting Saturday morning at 6:30 when the biggest attack against Israel in decades began. Israel's Von.
Okay, now I want to say something. Just I've watched a lot of different footage, and some of it is from CCTV cams and legitimate barricade breaking through and waiting for people to go through checkpoints and shooting them and taking their cars, and those type things are legitimate, credible entries. Some of the other stuff that I saw yesterday, and when you look at the Israeli defense system, a lot of it doesn't make sense, like it was allowed to happen. These days, to be able to believe this or that sometimes is very, very difficult. I think the thing that matters the most is, at this point, doesn't even matter, because the conflict is the conflict now, no matter what. And we have weapons that were left, $87 billion in U.S. arms, conveniently left there. Isn't that fascinating? Conveniently left there during the Afghan withdrawal, which is the stupidest thing I've ever heard of, probably. You don't leave $87 billion in weapons unless maybe you had an ulterior motive to let someone else use them. And then also weapons that were supposed to be in Ukraine are showing up over here as well. That's convenient. So anyway, right now with the state of the world and the reality of the Bible and what the Bible says Jerusalem will become a cup of trembling. And right now we have an organized Arab state caliphate going for Israel. Just stop and think about that. And then allegedly the United States, oh, we're friends with Israel. Under the Biden administration, that's just not true. If you go watch other countries' news, you'll see that there were some statements made by, let's see if it's still up in my feed. Nope. You can go look at Biden's old boss and hear what he said and see how that jives with the whole situation. I'm going to show you just another clip. So this is like a training video, but then it goes into something else. So just watch.
And breaking into Israel, Israelis have also been collecting dash camera and CCTV footage to understand how Hamas attacked. In one video, Hamas fighters can be seen entering a kibbutz, laying in wait for a car to open the gate, shooting the driver, and then slipping in. More than 100 bodies of Israelis were later discovered there. Another video shows what it was like to try to escape. The car racing away is shot in the windshield. The driver still manages to keep moving until more shots come in, and the vehicle loses control and crashes. U.S. officials say Americans are among the dead and missing.
Okay, now that scene right there, that's pretty interesting looking scene right there. It looks like a lot of cars were blocked from entry by a lot of people shooting at them, car after car after car. And I mean, you know, the reality is there's a lot of real footage going on here. No matter what, there's a conflict now. If you thought we were close to World War III with the Ukraine thing, now, if you don't understand, World War III is here. Now, understand this. The bombings are printed on your money. New York is printed on the $100 bill. There's a tidal wave printed on your $10 bill. And those are the videos I've been showing you guys for years. And the Lord had told me to warn everybody what was coming. And I've been warning everybody since 2007 publicly. I've been out in the public domain warning people. A lot of people out there are saying Jonathan Cleck's a false prophet because I showed you the Vatican's a snake. I showed you that there's a serpent race trying to consume a sheep race, which is the angels. So the angels are the sheep, the serpent are the demons within the host body system, and I've shown it to you ad infinitum. I mean, I can show it to you on greeting cards. Let me just show you something in one of the folders so you can see how obvious this is. Let me just pull up one of my folders and just show you how obvious this is now. Ready? Okay, so the demonic system is, they own the right side up, upside down system. Let me just pull it up on, here's a blade you can buy at Home Depot. It's called Diablo. You see the demon Demo Demon. Look right here. Look at the middle. Right side up, upside down. It's an inversion. See it right here? Ready? It's no different than that. This is what Satan owns. He owns the right side up, upside down system. Cleanse your hearts, you double-minded. Get it? So when you purge your heart through your mouth, you admit God to God, you deserve your punishment, you purge your soul of all the evil, and you admit it, you say it, then you publicly shame Satan, and you ask God to come in and get rid of that down and turn it to an up, and you get two ups, and your eyes become single. But there's those people that are purely evil, and they make statements, like I've had people make statements from that Gene Rebel camp and Karen and them, saying that I said it's okay to kill somebody if they're a double downer. And then I've heard other people parrot that nonsense. That shows me something very profound, very profound. Anyone that lies and says that kind of stuff, that's pretty serious. It's pretty evil. So anyway, there it is. Look, Demo, Demon. Look at the moniker. Right side up. Look, ready? Boop, boop. Upside down. It's a reversal. That looks just like my parachute, though, doesn't it? V for vengeance, because God's going to take vengeance on that system. Why do you think the Lord had me see the letter V and the number 4? V for vengeance, and then upside down. V for vengeance. And that X right there, that represents the female energy that's in all of us, and the Lord God paying for that. That's the other energy. That's the other energy that's in us that defiles us. That's what it is. Because there's good and evil. The evil is from the pit, twin female energy. And then you have God from heaven, male energy, and he comes into the system. The two commingle. And if you don't get converted back to God, then you go to the pit. Satan gets you. He gets your soul. And so there's the parachute that I had. How is that any different than right here? So mine's V for vengeance. God's going to take vengeance on this system right here. See it right here? My V for vengeance? There's no way that's even possible. Let me show you how simple this is. You see that? You see death? You see the eyes or hearts? Three hearts, one, two, three, angel of the bottomless pit. One, two, three, angel of the bottomless pit, the number 3 in the Bible. All right, if you look up Strong's 3, now watch this. Let me just turn it upside down so you can see what it really is. It's just a female. Eye, mouth. So right in front of your face, death. Death is female energy. That's it. That's all there is to it. It's just not even close to arguable. Now let me show you. A girl had a tattoo the other day. I went to eat lunch, and on her back, she had a big fairy on her back, and it was a naughty fairy. And she had her whole back open, and I was like, oh, wow, check out that crazy tattoo. And then she had on her elbow a heart made out of barbed wire and a scorpion. What's in the pit? The scorpions. Why do you think the Bible says, I give you power over all the enemy to tread on serpents and scorpions? The serpent race is attached to the pit where there's a locust, aka scorpion, that's feeding off you your whole life. I mean, it's the most obvious thing in the world now. The Vatican. The pillars, the posts, have scorpions. I'm sorry, have locusts on them. Locusts are the same as the scorpions because the locusts have tails like scorpions, so they're one and the same. So when this girl has a tattoo of barbed wire, look at the, see the two up, two down, two up, two down. That's your barbed wire right there making a heart, and there's a scorpion. So she's manifesting that energy, no doubt about it. I told you the other day when the Lord told me, go in Half-Price Bookstore, I want to show you something. He walked me over to a CD rack, and I read Vertical Horizon. He said, get it. You see that right here? You see that right here? V for vengeance. The Lord's about to take vengeance on the system. The system. If you're still attached to the system, this is the system. Right side up, upside down is the system. Male and female energy within you. If you haven't been turned back to God and been converted, then you're part of the system, and the V for vengeance goes for anybody that's still part of the system. You have to be born again. You have to be spiritually reborn, or you're part of the system, just like that demon Diablo blade. It is exactly the truth. 350 on my sleeve, Anna Crino. to vigorously judge from down to up. Do you understand? The Lord gave me the keys to the kingdom of heaven, and I'm trying to give them to you. The end is at the door, you guys. Okay, I love you in Christ, but you know it's coming now, don't you? All right, so I'm going to try and make this short. I've been having, it looks like all my computers are under attack. The hackers are out. There's a concerted effort to take me down, and that's what they do. That's what Satan does not like Jonathan Kleck. I picked up the rock and ratted out his whole kingdom. So he's not liking me very much. Too bad. Don't care. All right. Now, I love you guys in Christ. Now, I want to play the song that I heard that night all those years ago before I said, Lord, I just want to know the truth. I'm going to play the song that I knew in my heart before I ever cried out to God and asked to know the truth. I knew in my heart somehow things were coming to an end. And here I am 20-something years later, and I know it's true. So, I love you. I love you in Christ. Jim and Karen, Kathy, Chuck, all you guys, I love you in Christ. God have mercy. Wouldn't it be nice just to leave everybody alone? Wouldn't that be cool? I left y'all alone. I didn't sue you. I didn't drag anyone in court. I left everybody alone. I relocated a bunch of people that Jim and Karen had fleeced, taken. Bunch of people took money. They took money from a bunch of people. I just left everybody alone. I relocated handicapped people, people that didn't have anywhere to go. I did it using the people from the ministry. And you know what? All I did was get hated by the Solomons and the Edges and the Gene Revel hate channel. That's all. That's just a fact. That's just 100% truth. No one ever left me alone. Why not just say, God bless you, Johnny. Thank you for not suing everybody. Thank you for not making it a nightmare. You're welcome. But instead, they repaid me evil for good. That's just a fact. So the Bible says you reap what you sow. I know that's true because the night I got saved, the Lord showed me you reap what you sow on the wall when I walked out of that alley, and I knew it was going to be a tough future because I knew my previous life I had sown some things that weren't good, but I got to reap them, and I got to go through many years of the consequence engine turning. So that's the way it works. Anyway, but I mean this, peace and grace to everybody. I pray that God protects everybody, and I don't want anybody to have anything bad happen to them. That's truly my heart. I would like everybody to leave me alone, though. That'd be nice. And to also leave the people alone from the ministry and quit being mean and hateful to them. Wouldn't that be nice? Just everybody live and let live. That would be awesome. All right, so peace and grace on that. And then I would like to play Sarah Brightman, Time to Say Goodbye. Because when I saw that Night in Eden program, the last thing I saw was Time to Say Goodbye, and I just wept. All right, let me give you guys a hug. We never know when we're going to get our last hug. That's you. This is Johnny. I love you guys, and... And I'll see you at a party real soon. I hope I see everybody there. And when I say everybody, everybody that's given their life to Christ, everyone that's willing to stand up for the truth, those people that are dead set online, well, there's nothing I can do to help anyone that won't turn from their lies. All right, guys, here we go. Ready? Sarah Brightman, Time to Say Goodbye. I mean, when the Lord walked me into a bookstore and he told me, pick up this CD, and I looked at that, really, Vertical Horizon, V for Vengeance, because this is what caused the whole thing. Hey, she's upside down. Really, V for Vengeance? There's no way. It's not even possible. So, I mean, it's just crazy. Oh, you know what? Oh, my God. I'm sorry. I forgot. I've got to go through Gideon. The rapture is in Gideon. I'm sorry. I almost forgot. Look at this, guys. Behold, when I come to the outside of the camp, it shall be that as I do, so shall ye do. When I blow with the trumpet, and all that with me, then blow ye trumpets also on every side of all the camp, and the sword of the Lord, and the sword of the Lord and Gideon. Okay, look at what this says. When I come to the outside of the camp, the word camp means is encampment. of travelers or troops, an army. Wow, that's just like Genesis 2. Angels, locusts, stars, or even the sacred courts, army, band, tents. I mean, really? Angels, locusts, and stars? Okay, let's go here. Ready? And he said to them, look on me. So look on me. Think about looking at the Lord when the Lord shows up. Beholding the Lord, his face. Lo, behold, when I come to the outside, to the edge, the end, the infinite frontier or border of the camp, the angels, locusts, and stars. When I come to the edge, it shall be, look at that, 1961. Does that, remember 1961? To exist, I exist. That as I do, you shall do also. When I blow with a trumpet, a shofar, as giving a clear sound, but it says in the sense of incising. Do you know what incising means? To cut away. When you cut something, like if you're going to incise a piece of flesh, you cut a piece of flesh away. So look at this. When I blow with the trumpet, in the sense of incising, cutting away, as giving a clear sound or a curved horn. And all that with me blow their trumpets to clatter, to slap, by analogy, to drive, to become bondsmen by hand clasping. When all them that are with me, then blow ye the trumpets also on every side. Look at this, a circle with or without preposition around to encompass all the camp, and say the sword of the Lord and Gideon. So look at the word camp, the encampment of travelers, angels, locusts, stars. That's impossible, you guys. And they say the sword of the Lord, the self-existent eternal Jehovah, and of Gideon, feller, that is warrior. Okay, and as I read this, and I went down and I read this, and they stood every man in his place round about the camp, and all the hosts ran and cried, says to split ears, to shout for alarm or joy, and fled to vanish away. As I was sitting on my bed this evening, and I heard the Lord tell me, I want you to go out, you need to go reach out to everybody. I heard that this was analogous to the rapture. Think about it. We're the clay pots. And the light's in us. When the clay pots break, and the light, and they lit the torches and blew the trumpets, and what happened to the enemy? They turned on each other. And then fled. What's going on in the world? When the trumpet blows, what's going to happen? The light that's in us leaves. And the enemy's just going to be left here to kill each other. That's what's going to happen. Anyway, that's the best I can explain it. It's very simple. But if you go read through the vocabulary of it, it's very obvious to me now. Anyway, I love you guys in Christ. I'm exhausted. My eyes hurt again really bad. It's been really difficult to make it in front of the screen this long. Hang on one sec. Okay, so now I'm going to play. It's time to say goodbye. I think it's time to say goodbye, guys, real soon. So pray for the world. Pray for your enemies. Bless those that curse you. Do good to those who despitefully use you. Okay? God bless you guys.
When I dream, the words are missing. inside of me, the light you see, that you met in the darkness. Time to say goodbye. Horizons are never far. Would I have to find better love without the light of my own?
So, I've never heard that song in English, ever, never. Dave, I asked Dave to put Time to Say Goodbye in the show notes for me so I could play it. How crazy, Time to Say Goodbye, Horizons Are Never Far. I just find it really crazy that within the show notes, that the Lord took me into a bookstore and had me pick up a CD after he showed me Time of Judgment is Here. And it says Vertical Horizons. I've never, ever heard that song ever in English. Anyway, my heart's broken for the world. My heart's broken for a lot of people right now. Because I know a lot of people are not going to make it out of here. I know a lot of people that put their faith in Jesus, and for those of y'all that did, God bless you. I love you in Christ, but just stay the course no matter what. Trust in Jesus with your whole heart. Lean not into your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge the Lord, and He will direct your path. Anyone that does evil to others, you've only done it to yourselves. You reap what you sow. Peace and grace. Take care. Love you in Christ.